For many families, curling up with a good book is a bedtime ritual.
A nice one. ABC7's Linda Yu recently talked with an author and illustrator who has a unique way to bring some fascinating children's stories to life.
As a parent, I know that bedtime storytelling time is such an important, important time. And if it's a treasured bedtime ritual for you and your family, or maybe you'd like to introduce your children to the wonders of a bedtime story, there is a beautiful new book out. It is a must-have. Wait till you see this. The author and the illustrator is Laura Robinson, and this book actually transforms a child's bedroom into a magical shadow theater. And Laura joins us now with more about this. You had this idea when your first child was little. Tell me about that.
Well, I used to rock him at night, late at night, and I loved to watch the images of the shadows of trees moving across the wall as the cars would drive by. And so as I sat there rocking him, I thought, wouldn't it be great to have a book where rather than have the illustrations in the plane of the page, if we were to cut the page and use a flashlight, they could actually be released and transform the child's bedroom into a theater.
Okay, and so she finds it, and this is it. This is the book, and this one we're going to talk about right now is called William and the Christmas Moon. And this is how it works, okay? This book comes, and you can stand it up if you want to, all right? And then there are these beautiful silhouettes that are cut out here. But you provide a flashlight, all right? And you just turn the flashlight on so you can see that there's this light. And then you can shine it out on... Okay, and so we're going to show you in a better way so you can see all of these beautiful silhouettes that you've created. So talk about the story on this now. This is William.
Yes, this is William, and on Christmas Eve, he goes to the window to look for Santa Claus.
Yeah, and he's going to stay up and wait for Santa Claus?
He wants to see what those presents are that are going to be coming underneath his tree.
Okay, now it turns out, though, he actually falls asleep.
He
dreams about, who's this?
He dreams about his grandfather. And this is the point of the book, that rather than being concerned about the presents that were wrapped under the tree, William makes a discovery about the beautiful rural landscape. And he sees that actually his true presents this Christmas are the ability to appreciate this landscape,
right,
and also the love of his grandfather.
And so he makes this travel with his grandfather, and he goes through different scenes in the forest, and we see the deer there. And then ultimately in his dream, he also does see who's that.
He sees, well, that's his grandfather and he, and it looks just like Santa Claus, because this is his discovery, that the time that he spends actually in his dream flying through this landscape becomes more special than Santa himself, as he learns how treasured he is.
And then finally Santa does come along.
Yes.
So, yeah, that Santa does. Okay. So a beautiful idea. I mean, I love this, that you can... with your child, all right,
yes,
you can set this however far back you need to, all right?
Right. It can get very, very large on the wall.
With these different silhouettes, and the child can keep this, and as you go along and tell the story. And as I read the story, too, I'm thinking that, you know, with your own creativity or with your child, you can start to also add to the story.
Yes, absolutely.
To.
Certainly.
And there are other books?
Yes, there's a book, the very first book I wrote, called William and the Magic Ring, and that's where William overcomes his fear of the dark.
And then you're working on some other ones, too.
Yes. The next one, William will be camping and seeing images on the side of his tent.
Oh, really? That's a great idea, too. Okay. Because I'm thinking when my son was little, we used to almost build a little tent in his bedroom sometimes. So you can climb in there and you can do that story.
Yes.
And then so you have other ideas that are coming along, too.
Absolutely.
All right. That's wonderful. Now, the book used to only be available at a museum in Boston, but now you live in Chicago.
Yes, and we brought it to Sawbridge Studios. So they have stores in Winnetka as well as in River North.
Okay, great. We love these books, and it's a great holiday idea and a great idea to start a tradition with your children, too. Laura, thanks very much.
Thank you.